Let's see, let's first do the check. Sasika, guys, my name is Julia and I am from Latvia, from ISMA University. And I'm working for the admission office here. Here today I will give you some brief information about the study, about the Latvia itself. I will give you the information about the course structure, about the fee structure, anything what you can be interested in your future, for your future career, for your future practice, for your future moving to us. So let's start. I will give you just some information about the Latvia as well. What is the Latvia and where is the Latvia based? Latvia based in Europe. We are part of the Baltic countries. There's three Baltic countries in the Baltic states, which is Latvia, Estonia and Lithuania. So basically we have the wonderful location. We have a sea next to us. So we have a very small, beautiful country, which is very, very, very welcome for the international students here. Latvia is one of the biggest cultural centers in Europe. We have a beautiful, huge market here. We have a beautiful nature. We have a lot of nice, welcoming English-speaking people here. We have a little waterfall. We have, as I already mentioned, we have a sea as well. So we have, so we have everything what you need for your future suitable and comfortable stay here. Well, so ISMA University is a private university. We work over 25 years on the market of education. And we have, we are one of the biggest universities in the Baltic world, which I have to mention. We have a huge number of the students from Asia. We have a lot of students from India here. We are one of the biggest SA universities with the biggest amount of Indian students here. So, first of all, I would have to tell you the information about the courses itself. Which courses we provide for our students, the ones who come and study with us. First of all, we are having like a program for the bachelor's, for the master's students. We have a program for the PhD as well. About the bachelor students, the ones who completed successfully their 12 classes in India, they can apply for study of the bachelor. We have a bachelor program, it's a professional program, which is duration of the course is 4 years. And the main courses for the international students will be the business administration, it will be the business administration and the sphere of the career. And the third program which we have IT for the bachelor. Or another thing which I have to mention as well, from the last year we have an absolutely new program which calls the music management. So this program I will come back a bit later when I will provide you more information about the courses. So this is the main four courses which we have for the bachelor. About the master students, for the master we have a standard MBA, the one which is very, very common in all the universities, and all the students, most of the students, I can tell you by my working experience, most of them, they're applying for the MBA. Around, let's say, 90% of the students are applying for the MBA. Also, they have a program for the computer system. So once you will complete the program of the IT, you will be a master of the IT system, which is very, very good. And please, I have to mention that as well, that in Latvia, it's one of the lowest schools of the education, and plus we have an international certificate and international diploma. So basically, if you complete your study here, it means that your diploma will be recognized everywhere. It will be in full Europe, in USA. So imagine, for such a small amount of the money, you can get a master of the IT. And then it's totally your decision. You can move, you can work in any big companies. We have a lot of students from India who worked, especially the one who completed the IT in the master, the one who worked here for the big international companies and as IT specialist. Right, what else I have to mention? About the structure, right, this one I told you about the bachelor. By the way, one of the most common for the bachelor courses is a touring course. Because most of the people, you know, especially when they just completed the study in school, they dream about the traveling and about this kind of stuff, so they're going and study for the 2 weeks. Because it's very interesting, you know, once you have this profession, you're traveling everywhere, you're getting involved in the travel process, you're getting involved in the working in the hotel business. It's very, very. I was the one who completed this program as well. But you see, the life turned out that I have to be, that I found myself here. So, what else? About the master's degree, about the PhD as well. This is one of the interesting things which I have to mention. PhD is a program the one for your doctoral grade. So once you complete your PhD, your master's program, even if it can be in India or it can be with us, any other places, you can apply for the PhD. PhD duration is the 4 years, but this is the wonderful, this is something really wonderful. I'm one of the PhD students here as well. This is very interesting experience because this is the scientific degree. So once you have, I will come back to your questions later on. So once you complete this one, right, so you'll be in the scientific world, which is very, very good level, like very high level. And with this, you can make sure that everywhere where you're going to move or you're going to stay here, you will be always with a job. You will not stay jobless because this is something really, not a big percentage of the people, they're having a PhD. So you have to think about that as well. So another thing which I have to mention, we have in ISMA, we have one of the modern methods of the study because we are University of the Information Systems, so we are following all the information systems. So basically we have everything, all the new generation programs. We have brand new computers with a good speed. We have all the requirements for all the students, you know, to study, all the online materials, everything what you can get. That we have a fully qualified staff. All of our staff, they've got a degree. It's not like in some of the places the people are working, you know, without even understanding what they do. All of our staff have at least, all the staff have at least master's degree. This is like a big one. We have a training for the students. Training is about, especially for the new students, the ones who are coming from the overseas. We have a lot of classes here. This is something very good because once you are here and once if you will decide to settle down here, it's going to be a very big bonus. Because this is one of the compulsory languages which you will have in your timetable. It's also for free and you can come even on Saturday. We have additional classes for the Latvian language. So this is a very good thing. We have a very good control of the students, of student progress. We are looking for each student. So for example, we have a department which is information department where I'm based as well with some of my colleagues here. So if any students have any problems, they can always come to us. We always find to come and to
their problem and help them.
So we will be very glad to see you here as well. What else I have to mention? Now I will mention about we have a very few agencies in India because now we left only with the very trusted one. CAAN World, one of the trusted ones. So we have with them a contract. They're based in London. And they're the one who is looking after all our students. So you can absolutely trust them. We have a contract, we have a strong relationship with them, so nothing will happen. About how to process the application, for example, if you decide to come and to study here. You will have to send to your agent, let's say, you have to send all education documents. For example, you have to send your documents for the 10 classes, for the 12 classes, then you will have to send your passport copy, and from this issue, you will need to see your English level certificate, or you can provide MOE as well, it will work. MOE is a certificate from the school where it's concerned that you are the one who got your study, on the 12th class study, you got on the English, English language. Once you have all these documents from your agent, once I have all the documents from the agent, what we do, we're issuing the offer letter. Offer letter, this is the, I hope that it will. Then I'm sending the offer letter. Offer letter, this is the provisional acceptance about the university is happy with all the documents and that we agree to accept you, but before to give your final agreement, the study agreement, we have to make sure that all the documents are fine. And because we have in Latvia, we have a specific academic center here, the one who is looking after all the students' documents, what we'll have to do, we'll have to send this for this double check, which takes about, let's say, it depends on how busy they are, but around 3-4 weeks. Then we're getting like a final answer from their side when they're saying that all their documents are still fine. They're happy to accept you, so then we're sending you the study agreement and the tuition fee invoice as well. Now about the tuition fee invoice, about the prices itself. So, the price for the study is 2,500 in a year, and plus, let me try to see the sound. Let me try to see the sound. Somehow. Я на звук так лучше. So, the price for the study is 2,500 for the academic year and 300 euro for the admission fee. The next thing which I have to mention about the gap acceptance. For example, students, the one who is applying for the master degree, it's okay if they've got a gap, there's no problem because most of the students, the ones who are applying for the master program or the PhD, they are, let's say, over 25, right? So there's no problem if you have a gap about even 7-8 years because the embassy, they understand that people, usually the ones who are applying for the master, it is students, the one who is going straight after the some years of the bachelor completion. So, another thing, about the bachelor, let's say it's not good, for example, if you show that you completed your program about a few years back and then you decided you've been doing nothing and then you decided to go somewhere. So at least you have to show something that you, what you've been doing all this time, this is good for your visa passport, let's say like this. Now, I will tell you another interesting thing, which is about Erasmus. What is Erasmus? Here in ISMA, we have a special European Union system which allows students to go to have the practice and the study or inside of the European Union. So, for example, there's an Erasmus program. For example, the one who is... there's two, let's say it like this. Two different Erasmus we have. One Erasmus is for the study. And then another Erasmus for the internship. For example, you completed your first year of study and then you decided you want to do some internship. So, we can send you to between the European Union countries to go for the summer practice. And then you will get paid and plus you will have some stipend from the European Union. There is a second Erasmus. A second Erasmus is about the study. Study, for example, you study with us for 1 year and then you decided you want to do your second course somewhere in a different university in a different country. So then in that case, because we have a lot of agreements with other universities here, so in Europe, so you can go and study second year or even the third year somewhere else in a different country. So this is the program called Erasmus. The practice Erasmus is about, let's say, about 3 months. Most of our students, I can tell you by my experience, most of our students, they're going to Spain, because Spain is wonderful, it's beautiful, it's a beautiful nature, it's a beautiful people there, happy people, and most of our students, they prefer to go to Spain. Another thing about the Erasmus Plus, Erasmus for the study, it can take from 3 to 12 months, it's totally up to you, and you are having space for the transfer to get there, and plus the European Union is paying your stipend for your staying, for your living expenses there, which is a big bonus as well. So basically, you don't have to pay extra, you just pay for your tuition fee here, and then you're moving and studying another university. Right. We have around 70 different partners in the European Union. I will tell you, but again, by my experience, I can tell you, but the most popular countries for the study, this is the Spain again, the same Portugal, Germany as well, then Czech Republic and Finland. About the practice, this is the best countries. I already mentioned most of our students, they're going to Spain. On the second place, I can tell you this is Greece, because Greece is also very, very, very good. And Bulgaria, Turkey, and this is the rest of the countries, but this is the main one. Okay, so about how much money you are getting usually. For the practice, you are getting the 500, around 5 to 550. This is your money which you're getting in euros. We're talking about euros. About 550 you're getting every month from the European Union government. Plus, you are getting paid from the place where you're having your practice, where you're having your internship. This is about from 250 to 300. So basically, in 1 month of the internship, during this summer break, you can get around, let's say, 800-900. It's totally up to you how many hours you will work and all the stuff, but about 800 to 900 euros in the month. Right. So, another thing. One of the bonuses which I have to mention about the Erasmus. One of the bonuses is about the traveling. Imagine this, you came to Europe. You know, it's like I don't even know how to tell this place. Huge population, huge different countries, there's different cultures. For you, it's like a very big bonus to travel to see the other people, other countries.
I will answer the question faster, okay? Thank you for this. So, about the opportunity to find new friends as well, because it's very good bonus. When I was a student, I used to go for different programs. I still have a lot of friends in different countries. So, about the great European and international experience as well, because you can put in your CV that you've been working in the different countries. This is a big bonus. Especially imagine if you are studying for the tourism or something and you're planning to work in the group. Another thing which I have to mention, we have from the last year, we have a great cricket team. We are one of the universities here, not all the universities, I can tell you, maybe two universities from all the Latvia having their own cricket team. We have a great cricket set, and our students, they're usually playing with the other universities, they're playing with other countries. So they're traveling to Ukraine, they're traveling to between the
Europe for all
the different tournaments. So if you know how to play the cricket, if you like cricket, you're more than welcome to join our team and we'll be glad to see you here and to show the progress for the university, because we'll be very, very glad to be a good cricket player. So another thing that we have a volleyball team as well. This is a very good thing because, you know, once you have a lot of energy and you don't know where to spend, volleyball is just a great opportunity for you to spend your energy. Now let's come back to the thing which I have to mention as well. This is about the new program, the one which I already say to you, music management. You can this program based under the program of the business administration, but it is something really, it is the kind of innovation here, because not like again, it's not very common thing that the universities are doing this kind of thing here, because it costs for the university a lot of money, it costs a lot of resources to get into the point. So the main goal of the music management is specialization for the entrepreneurship course, to train the professionals to work into the areas of management, in show business, producing the club promotion, the concert touring, and the record industry, the PR working with the media, and those links with the world of show business. An additional component of the program can be a training course on the musical instrument. So guys, imagine you will find out how to play the guitar. About the vocals, which I don't have, I wish one day. Percussion instrument, auditory technique. So you will have a wonderful, they will explain you how to talk. They will put your voice into the right place where it has to be. And then the acting technique as well, the emotional aspect of the audience. So basically the main topics which they are going through, this is the music production, sound directing, imagine how interesting is that. The theoretical emotional impact of the audience, the music, the basic of the music management and the advertising.
Using startup business, history of the popular music, we will not go anywhere without the history, which is the truth, and the types of the music demands from Latvia and contemporary Eastern Europe. So basically you will not just know about Latvia, it's going to be about all the Europe.
Plus, every month they have one, two different guest lectures.
Guest lecturers, the people, the one who are involved in the music industry, and the one who got experience, like the singers, promoters, all of them, they're coming to us and they're giving, they're sharing the experience about how it works and how you can be success on the story. If, for example, one day you will decide that I'm the one who was born for that.
As well, they're having the real practice in the music studio since the first course. So basically, we're renting like a studio. So basically, we're getting like a practice from the, we're renting the studio. And our students are coming here and trying to record their songs, the music, so it's, imagine how interesting that I would like to use. In my time, if it would be something similar like that, I would love to go for it. But unfortunately, at that time, it was very, very less programs here in Latvia.
Let's see now, let me have a look about the questions that have like, there is Ishvar Bhatti saying hello Ishvar. Then Ravi is asking, I did graduation 2019 with 67%. I have a 3-year gap and 2 years of the after graduation PhD program in Canada. Can I apply for PhD in Canada? Canada, you will need to ask Bavada. Avi is asking us, I did diploma in pharmacy 2015. After the Rakimis Pharmacy Company sales at the hand from the college program, this is know which program you prefer according to my profile. This is the question to Balan as well, she knows better. Is the university closed or working? This is another question. Officially we are on the lockdown, the same as you. But I'm here every day because I have a lot of files to process, so I'm working, so I have to come every day, unfortunately, yes. I also want to sit at home and watch the TV, the same as you, but I have no chance. What else? Where is the university located? We are located in Eastern Europe. We located in Latvia. Simran Brar is asking. For which intake application accepted? You know what we are doing now, because before we had just an intake February and September. Now we did move the intake to October, because by information, the one which we received from the Indian government, the borders will start to be open from September. So hopefully, until this time, we'll prepare all the documents. In October, you can come and start your course, hopefully. Then what else? Sadiq is asking, hello, mom. Is there any chance to go to internship to USA and Canada? It is, Sadiq. There is the option to go for it. Please contact the international department. We will explain you more about that. There is an option. For which intake for September / October. Change to get the scholarship from Latvian government as a foreign student. There is an option. Also come, because I know Sadiq, you are here in Latvia, so you can come to us. We'll explain you more about that. What else I have to tell you about Latvia? Let me have this made by any something. If you have any questions, go ahead. I will think what to show you more. Maybe I can show you some presentations. So let's have that. About this one.
This one I already explained you.
Prices I did explain you. The courses I did explain you. I'm not sure about, I think that it's once in 3 months or something, they're having the career day. What is the career day? Imagine, there is different employers, especially if the big international companies, they're coming to us and they're taking the application from our students. For example, our students are coming there, the companies, they're explaining about themselves, leaving their contacts, and then our students, they allow to apply and to get the work there as well. So this is a big bonus, because you know, in our complicated world, unfortunately we have to think about this material thing. And imagine if, for example, if you come one of the third year days, you came, you find an international big international company, the one where you can work. This is a big bonus because usually they are paying the very good money. Then you allow to do the to get involved into international to go to the international conference for the opening learning and the distance education. This is we have. Then we have a master classes about how to become successful, which you can attend absolutely for free. About internship experience, you about the sport competition now, you know. We have, by the way, this is a good thing which I have to mention as well. Every year we have the festival here. It's called ISMA Invites the Talent. What is that? For example, if you know how to dance very well, if you know how to sing, in that case, what you can do? You can be selected for this festival. And it's going to be like a huge concert where a lot of people are coming. There's a lot of producers are coming as well. So you can get involved in the process and to prepare yourself and to go on the stage and to sing. So this is the good festival for the ones who know how to do something. Good dancers, good singers, anything what you can do, this is a good option as well. Plus our team, the one who is doing the master's and PhD as well, we have our science magazine here. So they can get involved in the process of the giving their submitting their topics and submitting their publications to our scientific conference magazine, which is called the ISMA Scientific Journal. This is how it's called. And also, we have a project here. This is another thing which I have to mention separately. We have a project here. We do parties, let's say, about 5-6 times in the study year. The parties usually we're doing for the freshman party, for the new student, the one who came. So basically we are arranging the place with the music, with the DJ. We have a different competition there. So our students are coming. We are giving, like, you know, they're going through the full process of the freshman student. This is like, this is something that you have to see for sure. Then we have a party for the, before the new year we have a party. We have on the 8th of March, which is International Women's Day. Then we have a party for the Saint Valentine's Day, for the Halloween we have a party, and then we have a party before we are going to go for vacation. This is seriously way too much fun because our students, they can, like, seriously, like, they are just wonderful. They are coming, they are dancing like it's crazy, and it's, they're meeting together, they are having the opportunity to introduce themselves to them because there are so many students here, so at least they meet them to get a new friend. Another thing which I want to mention as well about when you're applying for the visa, you know that you have to pass the interview through the visa. So before you're going to apply, this is a good option. For example, what you will do is you prepare the good bank statement. What is the good bank statement? Good bank statement, this is the bank statement where it shows at least the minimum wage pay request is 5,160 euro so 5,160 euro, this is the minimum which you have to show in the bank statement. But as a good option, please guys, this is my huge request to you as well. When the embassy, they're checking your bank statement, they can see that, for example, 2 days back, you pulled the full amount. When you're doing the bank statement, please make sure that you put the money in advance, at least 2 months before, because then they will make sure that this money you put for your study, not just to show up the bank statement. This is one of the common reasons for the rejection. This is what I wanted to tell you. I'm trying to remember the main things which I have to mention as well. Okay. Is GAP accepted? I have a completed graduation 2014. It depends for which program you are applying. If you're applying for the master's program, that's absolutely fine. No problems at all. Then my visa, Hungary. My name is Canada Singh. Hi, Canada Singh. A nice English. Thank you so much. This is the experience. I'm a lecturer, by the way. That's why I'm a lecturer of the... If you will come and study here, I'll be your lecturer on the first course for sure. especially for the master students and for the bachelors. I'm the one who is teaching the first course. Tu esi ļoti skaista, es vēlos studēt jūsu universitātē.
This is Simran Brar is saying that I am very beautiful and if he wants to study. I hope he wants to study not because I am very beautiful, not because of this, but because
Simran Brar wants to get a very good degree. Let's hope like this. What else? I have guys ask me the questions. Maybe you want to ask some questions about the practice. Something about how you're gonna move for a while to Europe and just to study there. Doing your thing, Latvia. Yes, hi Himanshu. Himanshu, I think that you missed the part when I was explaining about the Erasmus, that we have two different types of Erasmus, one Erasmus for the study. By the way, Himanshu, you can apply.
Thank you so much.
Niku is saying you are very beautiful, Niku. Thank you so much, Niku. About the Erasmus, I already explained that, for example, you have two options. Niku, come and study with us, I'll give you a lecture. This is the study program and this is the practice program. You, Himanshu, you can apply for any of the programs that suit the country. Take the Germany, for example, and go and get study there for 1 year, at least. Then. Can you describe the admission process? Okay, about the admission process, it's very, very easy. I will repeat once again. Admission process looks like you have to send to your agent, which is the CAAN World, you have to send all your educational documents. Once again, I will repeat. What is the educational document? It's your 10th class certificate and the transcript, 12th class certificate and the transcript. Please, Hindi, South Africa, Kidal Halchal, this is what I can say. Then you have to send to your agent with the passport copy, MOE or English certificate. They will forward it to us. We will see all, we will check your documents if it's absolutely fine. We will send you the offer letter and then we will send you the invoice for the admission fee, which is 300. You're paying 300, we're sending the documents to academic center, they're checking, they're saying they're happy with your documents, then we're sending you the study agreement and the invoice for the tuition fee, which is 2,500. How much the university fee for the master? Just to avoid the confusion, we put only one price for the master and for the bachelor. We have the same price, which is 2,500 in a year and 300 euro for the admission fee. Himanshu is asking again, how is the Latvia dealing with the coronavirus and the safe to compare to other European countries? Guys, by the way, I will tell you about the coronavirus because everyone, all my students is asking me and a lot of agents is asking, everyone is asking, I will tell you. In Latvia, we have the smallest amount of the people, the ones who are having the coronavirus. Here we have about, let's say, every day, about 210 people, the new people, the ones who are getting. In total, it's about 800, but it's like, you know, the country is about 2 million. So 800 people is not too much. And imagine, like, you know, every day it's... It's increasing by one, by zero, by two people. So basically here is more safe than in any other country. So no need to be scared, you'll be absolutely fine. And just another thing which came to my mind, about the housing, most likely. This is one of the questions which you might ask, about where you're gonna live, about the accommodation. About the accommodation. Okay, about the accommodation. We have, we don't have the own place, we have, but it's very, very small and it's impossible to put our students here, all of our students here. So what we have the agreements with the places nearby. The places is, for example, like 2-5 minutes by the walking distance from the university. So basically, once you start studying here, what you can do, you can please, I'm reading the comments at the same time. I'm just getting very attention. So, We have a places nearby with whom we have a contact and they're accepting our students. About the accommodation price, let's say, if, for example, if you're taking the shared room with someone else, it's going to be two of you, let's say, then it's going to be about 150, 160 euros, which is a good thing, right? So it's not too much expensive. So compared to the salary, the one you can get, this is a very good price. But I will tell you again by my experience, because I'm sharing today like the right information. The most of the our students, they live in the apartment. So basically, they don't live in the temporary accommodation, which is the first student subscription. So they are living in the flat. They're taking, for example, with their friends, they're taking the flat, and they're living in this flat with the four or five people. So basically, they're taking about two, three bedrooms, and they're living all together in the community, because for them it's much easier. They cook together, they live together, they are supporting the culture of each other, they speak their own language, which is very, very good thing, because, you know, when you're far away from your home, you need some sort of the support. So this is a good thing as well. What else? You can, for example, you can live yourself. If you want, you can book a hostel here and live in room yourself. You will have just like a common kitchen and the same. This is about 200 euros if I'm not wrong, which is not too much expensive compared to our price as well. Let me see the question about the coronavirus that it explains. IELTS is required for the admission. IELTS is required for the admission if you have MOE, even if you're applying for the master's. If you have the MOE, it's a confirmation where your study language in the school was English, no need IELTS. Then, this is right here. Two years gap accepted in the case if you are submitting documents for the master or for the PhD, because if you're applying for the bachelor after 10 years of the completion, it might happen then, you know, the embassy, they will reject you easy because they will think that you have a different purpose to come here, not for a student, because all of us, they have the same topic, we want to come here, and all of us, we want to study here, to get the degrees and then to get free and to have a wonderful life. Hi, Abhishek. Abhishek Hassan is asking, I am studying in Turiba University, and now I want to study in ISMA. Abhishek, this is a very, very, very easy process, honestly. What I will need from you, send me by email your provisional transcript. Basically, this is the transcript, the one which the study department can give you in Turiba. This is the list of all the attempts which you already passed. Then I will have to transfer that to our study department. They will have a look and they will tell you for which semester we can accept it. It depends which course. For example, if you are studying for the engineering or something, you don't have similar courses, so most likely you will have to start from the beginning. This is the thing. And about another thing which came to my mind, it's about that most of the students, they are worried about they are moving from their families and they are trying to start to find a job. I will tell you, with job everywhere it's going to be complicated, but it's not up to us. It is something about the bad situation around the world. So, with work, most of our students, the ones who are coming for the bachelor's, they work in the restaurant, they work in the kitchen, they're doing the deliveries, they work as a taxi drivers. Most of our students, the one who is doing the MBA, MBA students, they are getting a better job. For example, hi Ishan, nice to meet you. Ishan is one of my students, he is my long-term student, he completed with us so many courses, now he is my PhD student. And by the way, Ishan and his wife Garnika are the cases of the successful life in Latvia. Because Ishan is the owner of the few restaurants and his wife is working as a senior manager in the IT company. So I'm very, very glad that I have such a wonderful people here. What else? Let me see if I have any questions. Mm. about this. How did it change? Hi, Sam. Hi. I have a student, the one is a very good example. I have a student, the one who is study, for example, they're doing the IT job, becoming a money. What is a money? Okay, so I have a lot of students, especially the ones who's doing like MBA or IT and the master. They're having a very good job. So please come and join them. I'll be very glad to meet all of you, and I'll be very, very glad to teach you all. As I already mentioned, that I'm a lecturer of the first courses of the MBA and the bachelor students as well. So I'll be glad to see you all here. Please, if you have more questions, if you have anything to ask, ask CAAN World. As I already mentioned, there are official representatives in Punjab. They will work a long time, so they know all the processes, they know even much better some of the processes than me. So, thank you. I don't know if you have any questions, I already explained you. I think we don't have any more questions, no questions, or have any questions. Thank you, Jaspal. Jaspal, he is he's from CAAN World. He is the one with whom we work long time. And by the way, I went to India some months back. I come back from India about 2 months back or something. We met with Jaspal there. Jaspal was coming to Latvia. So I like India so much. I know so many words which you don't want to know, because everyone was trying to teach me like different words and then making fun of me. But the India was wonderful. I visited Delhi, I visited Agra, I visited Gujarat, then Udaipur, then I was in Punjab for 12 days, so it was very, very wonderful to stay there. So hopefully I will come back one day and then to meet you all in person for any seminar. But for now, as you can see, the country is locked down, so we cannot do anything. So I have to wait until everything will be settled. Okay, guys, thank you so much for your timing. Simran Brar cannot calm down. Chandra Ho, Simran Brar. Vesta, you should call the Salvedo, please, the father of Kaskai. Simran Brar fell in love, as I can see. Simran, thank you so much for your good words. Thank you so much for everything, guys. Once, hopefully, see you soon. Maybe next week we'll do the seminar in the Zoom. So then we'll have like, you know, huge conference together. So maybe then you can talk and ask me the questions directly, not just like in the chat. Thank you so much once again. A lot of pieces, and bye-bye.